Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to create your first Java application using Visual Studio Code. So the first step is to check that the Java JDK is installed correctly on your machine. To do this, we have to open the command prompt. And in this window, we have to type java --version. So here, as you can see, I have the Java JDK installed correctly and this is the version that I am using. So for more information how to install the Java JDK, you can see the video link that is available in the description. Now let's close this window and let's go back to Visual Studio Code. Now we need to install an extension called Java Extension Pack. So let's click on this extensions button and here let's type Java Extension Pack. Now let's click on this first extension. As you can see, it is from Microsoft and it has been installed this number of times. To install it, we have just to click on this install button. Now the extension is installed correctly, so we can close this page and also we can hide the extensions. Now let's click on this Explorer button. So here we have two options, either to create a simple Java class or to create a new Java project. So first we will create a new Java class, then I will show you how to create a new Java project. So to create a new Java class, we have just to click on this Open Folder button. Then I will create a new folder on the desktop that I will call First App. Now let's click on Select Folder. Now to create a new Java class, I have just to click on this button. Then I will create a new class called MainClass.java. Now let's hit Enter. And here let's type Class. Now let's select this second option, and as you can see, using the code completion, we obtain this source code. Now we can remove this comment. And now let's add the main method, so let's type main, and let's select this first option. And as you can see, we obtain this source code. So we can see here that we have this line, which is not a Java code, it is just a line composed of two buttons. This one allows us to run this class and this allows us to debug this class. So as you can see here, there is no line number because this is not a Java code. Now let's add a statement that allows us to print some text to the user. Now we need to save this file, so we can click on Ctrl+S or also we can go to File, then Save. Now to run this class, we have several options. The first option is to click on this Run button. And we obtain this output. Now let's make some modifications. So I will modify the number. Let's save the file. And the second method to run this class is to make a right click, then to click on Run Java. And here we obtain this output. Now let's modify the source code again. Let's save the file and to run this class we can use this option which is Run Java. And as we can see here we have this output. Now let's modify the source code. Let's type 4 here. Let's save the class. And the fourth method to run this class is using this button. So I have just to click on this button. And here I obtain this output. Now let's add some statements into this class. So this statement allows us to create a scanner. This allows us to ask the user to provide his name. And then we will read the name of the user. And then we will print the name of the user as a confirmation. But here we have some errors. This is because we need to import this class. So we have just to put the cursor on this class, then we have to click on Quick Fix. Now we have to click on Import Scanner, and this import has been added, so the error disappeared. Now let's click on this Run button. So here it is asked to provide the username, so let's type Bill Gates. And let's hit Enter. And as you can see, this is the confirmation of the name. Now let's close this class. And also let's close this folder, so I have just to click on File, then Close Folder. Now let's create a new Java project. So we have just to click on this Explorer button, Then we have to click on create a Java project. So here I will select now build tools. Then I will create a new folder on the desktop that I will call Java projects. Now let's click on select the project location. And here I have to provide the name of the new project. So I will call it first project. So this project has been created and by default it contains one Java class in the source folder called app.java. So to run this class we can use this button. And here we can obtain this output. But here the problem is that we are using GDK 11, but we want to use the latest GDK, which is 17. So to modify the GDK, we can just go to the command palette. So we have to click on this button and then command palette. And here we have to type configure Java runtime. Now let's select this first option. And here we can see that we are using GDK 11. To modify the GDK, we have just to click on this button. And in this list, we have the available GDKs. So I will select this version, which is 17.0.1. Now we can close this page. And if I run this class again, we can see that this time we are using GDK 17.0.1. Now to create a new class into this project, I have just to select this source folder, then to click on this button, and here I will create a new class called mainframe. Now let's hit enter. So we obtain this source code, and I want this class to be a gframe. So let's add extends gframe. But here we have some errors because we need to import this class. So let's click on quick fix and let's click on import gframe. Now this import has been added and the error disappeared. Now let's add a new method into this class that I will call init. So this method allows me to initialize this class. That's why I need to add some statements. So this statement allows me to add the title, this allows me to set the dimension, and this allows the application to be stopped when I click on the close button of the frame, and finally I will make this frame visible. But here I have some errors, so I need to add the required imports, and I will select this first option. Now this import has been added and the error disappeared. Now let's save this file. But here we cannot run it because it does not contain the main method. So either we have to create a main method into this class or we have to go to app.java which contains the main method. And here we have to create an object of type mainframe. So let's do this. Now let's call the init method of myframe. And now let's save this class. To run it, I can click on this run button. And here we obtain this window. If I click on this close button, the application will be stopped. So the second method to execute this main frame is to add the main method into this class. So let's do this. Now let's save this class and let's run it. And here we obtain the same window. Now let's close this window and also let's close this console. So to see the different files of this project, we can use either this part of the Explorer or also we can click on Java projects and here we can see the available files. So here we can see that in the source folder we have two classes. In the next videos, I will show you how to add jar files to a Java project and how to create a new Java project using Maven building tool. Finally, thank you very much for watching and please subscribe to the channel.